What's going on, guys? It's Apple Critics, and in this video, I'll be reviewing the new iPod Touch features and basically giving you a recap and telling you some news about the new iPod Touch 5th generation. Now, the features include a 4-inch display, same as the iPhone 5, Siri, the Loop, A5 processor, and a 5-megapixel camera, and more. Now, the new iPod Touch has a 4-inch display. Now, the display has a resolution of 1136 by 640, and the new display certainly looks beautiful and tall, and it's a nice improvement from the iPod Touch 4G. Now, the iPod Touch 5G will come with an A5 dual-core processor responsible for smooth running of the iPhone 4S, so it's the same chip as found in the iPhone 4S, and the iPhone 4S was a pretty fast phone. Now the camera. Now the camera has been much improved from the iPod Touch 4G. It is now a 5-megapixel camera compared to a 0.9-megapixel back-facing camera on the iPod Touch 4G. Now it's going to be very crisp. It's basically the same as on the iPhone 4, but kind of improved, and it's more like the one on the iPad 3. So that's good to know that the camera got an overhaul, and it also does have LED flash, so that's definitely a surprise. And that's a nice addition to the iPod Touch 5G, and Apple says you can replace your point-and-shoot camera with this new camera. Now, if you look at the design, you can see that it comes in the colors of yellow, pink, white, blue, and a kind of black/blue color. So it's kind of like a navy color. Now, the 5th generation iPod Touch is the lightest iPod Touch to date. So if you thought the iPod Touch 4G was thin, and if you thought it was light, this one is only 88 grams. It's weighs less than the iPhone 5, less than the iPhone 4S, less than most iPhones, so that's good to know as well. Now, the iPod Touch does get a significant redesign. You can see that it has a matte back instead of that aluminum back on the iPod Touch 4G that can get scratched easily. Now, that's definitely a nice add-on. Now, the 30-pin dock connector is now removed, and Apple has introduced a newer, smaller, faster USB 3.0 compatible port for the iPod Touch. So the USB 3.0 speeds will be 10 times faster than the older USB, so that's pretty good. So if you're going to try and sync all your movies, photos, and everything, it's going to be blazing fast, and that's always good to have that type of improvement on a device of this caliber. Now, the battery will play 40 hours of music nonstop. Now, that is a lot of music, I must say, but that's just great battery life, too. Now, the iPod Touch will ship with iOS 6 pre-installed to take full advantage of the hardware as well. So that's definitely a nice feature. And that also means that Siri is on this new iPod Touch. So Siri was great on the iPhone 4S. I wasn't sure if they're going to bring it to the 5th generation iPod Touch, but they did, and that's a key feature. Now, it's always fun to have a virtual assistant by your side, but keep in mind this will only work over Wi-Fi since the iPod Touch does not have any cellular data like an iPhone does. Now, also, there will be redesigned headphones. It's not called the Apple Earbuds or Apple Headphones anymore. It's called the EarPods. So these were the same ones that were leaked. So the leaked ones were right. So that's definitely interesting to see. And they say that it's curved to your ear more, which is good to know. And those old headphones kept falling out of everybody's ears. So that's nice to see that they keep improving the most basic things. And the pricing. The pricing is a key point. Now, the pricing is definitely a key part to the device. Now, the price of the new iPod Touch is 32 gigabytes at $300 and 64 gigabytes at $400. Now, that's quite a bit, but once again, you get all those good features, so that's good to know. And the new iPod Touch will be available sometime in October. So thank you for watching this video. Once again, this was Apple Critics. Please be sure to subscribe, like this video. Please follow me on Twitter at twitter.com/applecritics. Like my Facebook fan page at facebook.com/applecritics. And thanks for watching, and leave a like as it helps me produce more videos. Once again, guys, it's Apple Critics, and thanks for watching.